Good morning, children. In the last chapter, you have studied about sets. What is a set? How to represent a set? Subset of a set, and operations on set. So today we have to learn the new chapter, chapter 2, relations and functions. In this chapter, the first part is Cartesian products of set. Cartesian product or cross product. Another name is cross product. So, what is the meaning of this Cartesian product? So, let us consider one example. Suppose I have three bags of different colors. One is red color, then one is yellow, the other one is green. So, three bags of different colors and two umbrellas. One is black color, the other one is white. How many different ways I can carry these items? So I can take red color bag with this black umbrella, that is one possible case. Or I can carry yellow bag and white umbrella, or red bag. If I write in proper order, red bag with white umbrella, that is also a possible case. Then yellow bag and black umbrella, yellow bag and white umbrella. Then we have green, green with the black, green with white. So these are the possible cases. In these different ways, there are six different ways I can carry these items. So if I represent this as a set, let A, so this means the set of bags, okay. And another set B, B is equal to set B comma W, that means set of umbrellas. Then here we can write as ordered pairs. So A cross B, look here, A cross B, or this is known as cross product or Cartesian product. So this means it is a set. Set of what? Set of ordered pairs. Each one is known as ordered pair. So, set of ordered pairs of elements from A and B. So, that is known as A cross B or Cartesian product or cross product. So, what is the definition? If P and Q are two non-empty sets. Non-empty set means it is not a null set. P is not a null set, or P is not an empty set. Q is also not an empty set. So if P and Q are two non-empty sets, then P cross Q is the set of ordered pairs of elements from P and Q. Here A cross B, it is a set of all ordered pairs of elements from A and B. So this one is in roster form. Last chapter you have studied what is roster form and set builder form. So this method is known as roster method, roster form. Then how can I write this as set builder form? For set builder form, we have to represent this by variables. So I can write this represented by x comma y, ordered pair x comma y, such that x, this first element from which set? All these first element, red, yellow and green from A, and black and white from B. So the first element from the first set and second element from the second set. So this is the meaning of Cartesian product or cross product. So if A and B are two non-empty sets, then A cross B means it is the set of ordered pairs of elements from A and B. In set builder form, we write set of ordered pairs x comma y. You can write A comma B, whatever, x comma y, such that the first element from the first set and second element from the second set. So you say, how we write B cross A? B cross A means, so by this definition, B cross A means the first elements from B, second element from A. So B cross A, we have to take B as First element, black umbrella with red bag. Okay. Then black with yellow, black with green. Then white umbrella with red bag, white with yellow, white with the green. That is B cross A. So you compare A cross B and B cross A. Are they same? Not same. In smaller classes, you have studied coordinate geometry. So 1, 2. Is 1, 2 is equal to 2, 1? Definitely not. 1, 2 means x coordinate is 1, y coordinate is 2. So first we check x axis where is 1, then we check y axis 2, then we mark the point. But this point is 2 distances from the origin on the x axis and 1 unit on y axis. So these two are different. So two ordered pairs are equal means what is the meaning? 1, 2 must be equal to 1, 2. So two ordered pairs are equal means first elements corresponding first elements are equal, second elements also equal. That's the meaning. So we can say that if xy is equal to 3, 4, ordered pair xy is equal to ordered pair 3, 4, then we can say that x is equal to, what is the value of x? This x is equal to 3 and y is equal to 4. In that way we can find the variables. Now another result. So A cross B. A cross B means cross product or Cartesian product of A and B. That means set of ordered pairs of elements from A and B. If either A or B is empty. Empty means no elements in that set. Either A or B is equal to empty set, then A cross B is also empty. So we can't list the elements. Okay. So either A or B is an empty set means A cross B is also an empty set. Then another result is if either A or B is an infinite set, there are infinitely many elements in that set, then so as A cross B. So if A is an infinite set, then A cross B is also an infinite set. If B is an infinite set, then A cross B or B cross A is an infinite set. Now we can consider some more examples. Let P is equal to A comma B, Q is equal to C comma D. What is P cross Q? P cross Q means set of ordered pairs of elements from P and Q. So first element must be from P, that is A, A comma C. Second element from Q, A comma D. Then I can write BC, then BD. Okay, so this is P cross Q. So what is Q cross P? C comma A, C comma B, D comma A, D comma B. And we can write as this P cross Q not equal to Q cross B. Okay, when we compare the ordered pairs A comma C not equal to C comma A, A comma D not equal to D comma A, so P cross Q and Q cross P are not equal. Now another example. Let 1, 2. What is R cross R? R cross R means the Cartesian product of elements from R. From R itself, we have both the sets are R. So R cross R means 1, 2 cross 1, 2. That's the meaning. So we can write ordered pairs 1, 1. Both elements from R. 1, 1. Then I can write 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 2. This is the meaning of R cross R. And this R cross R means ordered pairs that represents points in two dimensional plane. These are points in the xy plane. Now another example. Let A is equal to set 1, 2, 3. B is equal to set 5, 6. And what is A cross B? Set of ordered pairs of elements from A and B. First element from A, second element from B. So 1, 5, 1, 6, 2, 5, 2, 6. Then 3, 5, 3, 6. These notations are important. You have to write the set symbol inside bracket, comma separated by commas. Now another result is, so look these three examples. What is the number of elements in P? In this example, what is the number of elements in P? Number of elements in P is equal to 2. Number of elements in Q, that is also 2. Then what is the number of elements in P cross Q? Count how many elements? 1, 2, 3, 4. Here also 4. So P cross Q, there are 4 elements. So if we multiply 2 and 2, we get 4. Here we have number of elements in R is equal to 2. So number of elements in R cross R, it is 2 into 2. 2 here, 2 here. 2 into 2 is again 4. Here number of elements in A, 3 elements. Number of elements in B is 2. What is the number of elements in A cross B? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 3 into 2 gives us 6. So we can generalize. The general result is, if number of elements in A is equal to M and number of elements in B is equal to N, then what is number of elements in A cross B? Number of elements in A cross B is equal to M into N. You have to multiply that. Okay. Now we can do problems. So the first question, if ordered pair x by 3 plus 1 comma y minus 2 by 3 is equal to ordered pair 5 by 3 comma 1 by 3, find the values of x and y. So here two ordered pairs given as they are equal, x by 3 plus 1 comma y minus 2 by 3 is equal to 5 by 3, 1 by 3. Two ordered pairs are equal means corresponding first elements equal, second elements also equal. That's the meaning. So we can write x by 3 plus 1 is equal to 5 by 3 and y minus 2 by 3 is equal to 1 by 3. So y is equal to 1 by 3 plus 2 by 3. That is 3 by 3 is equal to 1. Here x is equal to, x by 3 is 5 by 3 minus 1. That is x by 3 is, 5 by 3 minus 1 means it is 2 by 3. 3, 3 cancel. So x is equal to 2. So using that result, corresponding, equate the first elements, equate the second elements. So we get the values of x and y. Now the next one, if A is equal to set minus 1, 1, find A cross A. So A cross A means set cross minus 1, 1. Sorry, okay, A cross A. Now we can write as set of ordered pairs, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, 1, 1, minus 1, 1, 1. Okay. Now the third one, A cross B is given as set of ordered pairs A comma X, A comma Y, B comma X, B comma Y. We have to find A and B. What is A? What is B? So A cross B means set of ordered pairs of elements from A and B. The first element from the first set and second element from the second set. So here the first element you have to write as set A, second elements as set B. So what is A? First elements A and B. Okay. And B means the second elements X comma Y. So when we do A cross B, we get this. 2 elements and 2 elements, 2 into 2, 4 elements in A cross B. Let A is equal to set 1 comma 2, B is equal to set 3 comma 4. Write A cross B, then how many subsets will A cross B have? List them. So, first we can write A cross B. A cross B is equal to set of ordered pairs 1, 2, 3, 4. So, 1 comma 3, 1 comma 4, 2 comma 3, 2 comma 4. 2 elements in A, 2 elements in B. So, number of elements in A cross B is equal to 4. Now, how many subsets? So, in the last chapter you have studied, if number of elements in A is equal to n, then how many subset for this set A? Number of subsets is equal to, number of subsets is equal to 2 raised to n. Okay. So, using that result, here in A cross B, how many elements in A cross B? There are 4 elements. So, what is the number of subsets? Number of subsets of A cross B. How many subset for this A cross B? 2 raised to 4, that is 16. And these 16 subsets we have to write. And the last chapter you have studied how to write the subsets of a set. Null set is a subset, the whole set is a subset. Then we know the pattern how to write the subsets. So, here we can write the subsets of A cross B. First we can write null set. Null set is a subset of every set. Then we can write singleton set. Singleton set means single element set, that is set of ordered pair 1, 3. Then set of ordered pair 1, 4. Then 2, 3. Then we have 2, 4. So, singleton sets over. Now we can write 2 element sets. So, 1, 3 with 1, 4. Then 1, 3, 2, 3. Then 1, 3, 2, 4. Then 1, 4. 1, 4, 2, 3. 1, 4, 2, 4. 2, 3, 2, 4. These are 2 element set. Now we can write 3 element sets. 3 elements means set 1, 3, 1, 4, 2, 3, comma 1, 3, 1, 4, 2, 4, then 1, 3, 2, 3, 2, 4, then 1, 4, 2, 3, 2, 4. Now count it, how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Now the last one is the whole set. That is 1, 3, 1, 4, 2, 3, 2, 4. So, these are the 16 subsets of A cross B. The Cartesian product A cross A has 9 elements. That means number of elements in A cross A is equal to 9. Here both sets are A. Number of elements in A cross A is equal to 9, among which are found minus 1, 0 and 0, 1. So, in A cross A, 2 elements are given. Find A. We have to write set A and the remaining elements of A cross A. So number of elements of A cross A is equal to 9 means, which implies number of elements in A is equal to 3. Then only 3 into 3 gives 9. Then, so what is set A? These ordered pairs are in A cross A, A cross B. If these are in A cross B means first element in A, second element in B. That's the meaning. But here these are in A cross A. So the first and second elements both are in A. So what are the elements in A? You can write minus 1, then 0 and 1. Then what we have to write remaining elements of A cross A. There are 9 elements, 2 are given. So we have to write 7 more. Therefore, remaining elements of A cross A are, so this cross the same set, minus 1. So the next set also minus 1, 0, 1. So minus 1, minus 1. That way we have to write. Then minus 1, 0. Minus 1, 0 is given. So that we don't want to write. Minus 1, 1. Then next 0. 0 minus 1. Yes, we can write 0 minus 1. 0, 0. Then 0, 1. 0, 1 is there. Now next is 1 minus 1. 1, 0 and 1, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 are there. Now the last question. A is equal to set 1, 2, 3. B is equal to set 3, 4. C is equal to set 4, 5, 6. Find A cross B intersection C and A cross B union A cross C. So the first part, A cross B intersection C. First we have to find B intersection C. B intersection means set of elements common to both B and C. So B and C you compare which are the common elements. Only one is there, that is 4. Now write A cross B intersection C. So set of ordered pairs of elements from A and this set, singleton set. So A is 1, 2, 3. So 1, 4, 2, 4 and 3. That finish. Now the second part is find A cross B and A cross C. A cross B. In A there are 3 elements, in B 2 elements. So number of elements 3 into 2, 6. 1 comma 3, 1 4, 2 3, 2 4, 3 3, 3 4. That is A cross B. Now A cross C. A cross C, there are 3 elements in A and C. So in A cross C there are 9 elements. 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6, then 2, 4, 2, 5, 2, 6, then 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, 6. Okay. Now we have to find A cross B union A cross C. Union means we have to write all the elements from this A cross B and from A cross C. A cross B union A cross C, which is equal to ordered pair. So 1, 3 is not here. 1, 3 is in A cross B. That we have to write. 1, 4 in both set. That also we have to write. Then 1, 5, 1, 6. Then 2, 3 is in A cross B but not in A cross C. That you have to write. All the elements you have to write. If any element repeats, write only once. 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5, 2, 6. Then 3, 3, 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, 6. Okay. So once again, we have to learn what we have to learn, or what we learned here, Cartesian product or cross product of two sets, cross product of or Cartesian product of two sets. So if A and B are two non-empty sets, then A cross B means set of ordered pairs of elements from A and B. So we write as ordered pairs. We take the first element from A and second element from B. If either A or B is an empty set, then A cross B is also an empty set. If A or B is an infinite set, then so as A cross B. And A cross B and B cross A are not equal. Then two ordered pairs are equal means the corresponding first elements equal, second elements also equal. The number of elements in A cross B is equal to number of elements in A into number of elements in B. Then only that much in that, then the problems. I hope all of you understood this part.